You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu es l'image de Dieu.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu es l'image de l'amour.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu sei il volto dell'amore.
You are a part. You are the face of God. You are the face of
love. You are the face of love.
I hold you in my heart.
I hold you in my heart.
You are my family.
You are my family.
You are the face.
You are the face of love.
You are the face
you
of love. I hold you in my
heart. You in my heart.
You are my family.
You are my family.
You are the face of love.
The face of love.
You are the face of God.
The face of God.
I hold you in my
heart. You in my heart.
You are a part of. You are the face of God,
the face of God.
You are the face of God.
Eres la luz de Dios.
I hold you in my heart.
Eres la cara del amor.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face.
Tu sei l'image de Dieu.
You are the face.
You are the face. Of God.
You are the face
of God. La luz de Dios.
You are the face.
You
of
are
God.
The face of God.
You are the face
tu
of God. You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu es l'image de Dieu.
I hold you in my heart.
Tu es l'image de l'amour.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God.
Tu sei la luce di Dio.
I hold you in my.
Sei il volto dell'amore.
You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face
you
of love.
You are the face of love.
I hold you in my heart.
I hold you in my heart.
You are my family.
You are my family.
You are the face
you
of. Of
you
God,
the face of God.
I hold you in my
I hold you in my heart.
You are a part
you
of
are
me.
A part of me.
You are the face
you
of God,
the face of God.
You are the face of God.
Eres la luz de Dios.
I hold you. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. You are the face
tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face
you are the face of God.
You are the face
tu es l'image de Dieu.
You are the face
you are the face of God.
You are the face
tu sei la luce di Dio.
You are the face
you
of
are face of God.
You are the face of God. You are the face.
You are the face of God.
You are the face.
Good morning, and welcome to Spiritual Life Center, a church that love is building.
Holy, the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel God's mighty power and God's grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place.
Let us pray. Dear God, we come together open and receptive to your will and your way. We seek to have your truth, your light, your ideas shine into our minds and hearts. We ask, loving Spirit, that you touch us this day, knowing that we have opened ourselves to receive your message, that you empower us and shine your light of truth upon our path. In grateful praise and with eager anticipation, we prepare to receive your magnificent good. Thank you, God. Amen.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for one like me. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for one like me. And there's quite enough hope and quite enough power to chase away any gloom. For Spirit, one Spirit is in this very room. And in this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough hope and quite enough power to chase away any gloom. For Spirit, one Spirit is in this very room, in this very room, in this very room.
In these quiet moments, we feel God's presence, as fresh and as new as if we were feeling it for the very first time. We find such joy here. The sweet peace of God that lifts us. The life of God that sustains and nourishes us. The light of God that guides and directs us. The love of God. The love of God that provides for us. We are so grateful to you, God, for your renewing presence in our lives. As we acknowledge God's presence, let us let these words be your words. God, you are my creator and sustainer. As I immerse myself in your holy presence, I trust that I will receive your divine guidance in the matters of my heart. And in doing so, I will come to find your perfect peace. God's light is filling me now, surrounding me, and I'm being guided and directed. I allow God's beautiful light to show me the way, and I know which choices are best for me. Each time that I look to the light of God for direction, I'm inspired to learn what I need to learn and to take the action I need to take. I trust God's brilliant, steady light. In each moment, I am renewed, refreshed, invigorated. The life of God blesses me physically and spiritually, and each cell is filled with intelligence and life. Each organ is programmed to function perfectly. I am a wondrous creation of a living, loving God, and I'm sustained by a power that reaches beyond circumstances to touch me at the very soul level, to make me new, whole, and complete. I feel God's life in the tissues of my body, in the very fabric of my soul, and I rest in the silence. In the silence. Thank you, God. Thank you for your blessed peace, your sustaining life, your guiding, inspiring light, your complete love. I'm now ready to go into this day with a renewed spirit. My thoughts are God thoughts, and my every thought is a prayer. I am a blessing, and today I will bless each person I meet with kindness and caring and compassion. I joyfully and gratefully go out to greet my world with love, love in my heart and on my lips. And for the goodness and the graciousness of a God that loves me so totally, I say thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. And now let us join together as we sing and pray the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. Forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
Rose and flows and angel hair and ice cream castles in the air and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way that you feel, as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave him laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. But now old friends, they're acting strange. They shake their heads, they say that I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained in living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life. I really don't know life at all.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Hi, everybody. Well, today's topic is near and dear to me, as they all are. Actually, it's my own spiritual practice made possible to share out here with you in the world. So marthacrete.com to contact me, my phone number, email, etc. All of that is there. And we're on the heels of a study some of us did together last month called I Am God, Wisdom and Revelation from Mystical Consciousness. And it got me thinking again and reflecting in my contemplations on the difference between existence and essence. And the trouble that I get into when I assert my agendas and assert my will onto the will and the way of life, God, creation. And the more I do that, the more stressful I get, the more stressful I am. So in growing psychologically, we naturally move toward increasing independence, interdependence, hopefully autonomy, and responsibility for self, and the surrendering to trying to control what cannot be controlled and controlling what we can, which is rare. So in growing spiritually, we increasingly realize how utterly dependent we are on life itself, creator, creation, whatever name you call it, universe, God, and therefore the will and the way, the grace of God that comes through life itself, creating itself, unfolding itself, that includes also the grace of relationships, of other people, of our professions, of our gifts that we have, none of which we are the creator of. that the gifts I have today are gifts that were given to me by whatever created me. So the benefits then of a psychological growth are clear. We improve. We stop some of our madness. I'm encouraged today and from the reading and the practice during this course study to not get stuck in individualistic focus, individualistic worship of self, individualistic rigidity about my way or the highway. So it requires me again to come back to lessen my subjectivity about my humanness, my human behavior, and include a subjectivity and an objectivity that includes the divine realm, my essence. So the more my focus gets on my existence, my demand for my existence, my wants and needs and shoulds and shouldn'ts for my existence, the more stressed, anxious, doubtful, worried I'm likely going to become and do become. So now that particularly since this focus on self, individualism is mainstream, I mean, even a revolution, and far more reaching than some of the other reformations we have, including religious, political reformations, industrial reformations, this individualistic self, is mainstream. It's in almost every book on our shelf. Many of us will address this self-help. So as it's become the prevailing opinion that we encounter anywhere, certainly in a therapeutic world, therapy world, the self-help world, the afternoon talk show world, the TikTok world, they all make clear the importance of childhood, what happened to us as children, and coming out from our traumatized, disempowered states, recovering from the past abuses, working through all of that to gain back some empowerment, to gain back some control that we never had, and working then through to self-acceptance. Then I accept what happened. I don't have to like what happened. I don't have to love what happened. And I've got to some degree, accept what happened to be less stressed, less anxious, less demanding, less willful, less stubborn, less angry, less rageful, less violent. And then to move to a new level, even beyond that, that is to be a humble, confessional witness of my own journey. So as good as these things are to a certain point and have absolutely helped me and countless people I know, and so therefore millions of people I don't know, this is only the beginning of the journey. Now, this will either frighten you or free you, the notion that after all the work we've done, all the work you've done, all the books you've read, all the church services you've attended, all the forgiveness you've done, all the repenting, all the contemplation, all the prayer, all the meditation, all the oming, that it's the beginning of a different journey, a new journey, an evolution in the beginning of becoming grounded in being. Grounded in being that could not ever be questioned and certainly would not be left unaffirmed. So from existence to essence. And as much as it's become the accepted truth that the best thing we can do is work on oneself, ourself, and encouraged, coached, counseled on not suppressing, depressing, repressing, denying feelings and fears and such, It's also important not to repress the realities of the world, of the whole existence, which includes imbalances and famine and poverty and destructions and things that are also included. So it can even feel alive. We feel more alive when we move out of vibrational arenas of shame and blaming and guilting and hating self to a new level of even to have anger. Dr. David Hawkins refers to it in the map of consciousness that anger is a higher feeling, a better feeling than depression, despair, apathy. So we got to be careful to keep moving, so to speak, to for our own progression and to tend to our evolution if we have any cause in that, if we can cause ourselves to grow spiritually, maturely, emotionally maturely, spiritually more maturely, and that we have not confused existence, self, with essence, higher self, or being. So as much as we attach enormous significance to processing and passing the feelings and the hurts and the experiences of our life, of our now decades for many of us, that we also move through the illusions, the temptations, the trials, the opportunities of it all, including the shadows and the disguises, the grace and the revelations, and that all of these are means. These are means, not ends. Never an end to this. So all the way to the grave. And that they are all these aspects of our humanity, of our divinity, our windows, doorways perhaps, not the destination, not the temple itself, but doorways and windows, passages into something far greater than we've yet experienced, yet discovered, or yet realized, regardless of how much we have realized up until now. So at best, the search for understanding, for sanity, for sobriety, for healing, whatever you call it, is noble, for sure noble. And it's not fully the illuminative, the path of being, the unity path, only to the degree that we are grounded in being. So we less and less and less need explanations as we move into being, a greater sense of being, a greater sense of essence. How will we know? A measure of your peace will inform you how much peace you can have, how quickly we can return to peace, how quickly we can atone, align with, accept what we cannot change. So the need, less and less need to blame. In one of the messages I gave a month or so ago, it's like, how do I know when I've done enough weeping? I've done enough weeping when I no longer have any blaming to do. So how do I know when it's enough affirming, enough prayer, enough meditation, enough silence, enough contemplation? when I don't have any blaming. I would not blame self, others, or God, life, creation for doing what it does. I also notice that I have less and less need for success, to be a somebody, to put up a stronger persona of being seen a certain way. Certainly less and less belief and fantasy that I have control, any control for that matter. So healthy spirituality points us to and through this psyche, the never changing or ever changing, always changing psyche, the always changing mental emotional stream, the always changing mood swings, the always changing belief systems, thought systems. So healthy spirituality points us through this ever-changing mental, emotional, psychological stream, ever-changing, always changing, to never-changing spirit. Never-changing, always present, always available, always unfolding, always breathing us. And where's our focus going to be? Having more demand for explanations, more demand for achieving, for success, for control, for being liked, for being loved, for being cared for being respected. Getting what we want, or more surrender, more acceptance of the will and the way of it, of creation itself, of creator itself. And to notice that when I get stressed, it's when I'm asserting my agenda onto reality, onto creator, onto life. So this mystery, the mystery of the universe, which is my greatest spiritual practice, the mystery of the universe has shown itself. All of it is included, and things I cannot comprehend in my limited human dimensional, third dimensional kind of approach. And not only has the mystery shown itself, creation has shown itself, that it also is creation. It is also creator. It is also creating in its own accord. It's okay as it is. It's enough. You're enough. I'm enough. I'm okay. You're okay. And no one, including you, including me, including ourselves, needs to be blamed anymore, nor shamed anymore, or worshiped. Less worship of the self. Also, less blaming, self-hating, shaming self. And herein lies the freedom of the children of Creator, the children of God. And if that's not liberation, if that's not freedom, then what could it possibly be? So I'll read one of the poems from the text. And it is entitled, "We Don't Really Do Anything." And this is a poem accessing mystical consciousness. So I encourage you to receive the words and just be with it instead of trying to even follow along. We don't really do anything. In I am God consciousness, things just happen. Divinity transmutes the self. Divinity transmutes the self and lives filled with spontaneity, wonder, flow, and synchronicity. The one in the many. Lives fill with greater love and compassion. Always, 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 always perfectly choreographed by the Creator. We are not in charge of this pageant. And this is my favorite part so far. We're not in charge of this pageant, nor can we improve it. Freedom. Did you ever really make a decision in your life? Or did things just change and you called it your decision? Let go of the wheel. Imposing our agendas on creation is what causes problems in the first place. Imposing our agendas on creation is what causes problems in the first place. Let the music of the spheres lead you back to the garden. Let the music of the spheres lead us back to the garden. Let's rejoin the celebration. Existence or essence? Where will we focus today? And what direction will we send our energies in today? Liberation, freedom, essence, being, beyond the concepts. Blessings and love. Namaste to your being.
Let the song Let the world sing a new hallelujah. Can you get excited, church? From Africa to Australia, from Brazil to China, from New York down to Houston. Please honor our special guest all the way from Uganda. This is the African Children's Choir. We love Uganda.
We are grateful to Michael W. Smith for this beautiful music. Thank you, Nancy Ingalls, for your marvelous singing this morning. And Reverend Martha, what a powerful message. We are grateful. And we are pleased that each of you could join us for this service. We invite you now to join in our prayer of sharing. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And we do ask that you support Spiritual Life Center with a donation to this ministry. There are four ways to do so. The first is online through our secure website, www.slctroy.com/give. A second way, mail a check to Spiritual Life Center, 41340 Fox Run Road, number 106, Novi, Michigan, 48377. A third way is to call my cell, 248-925-6214. Speak directly to me with credit card information for a one-time charge. A fourth way is to go to our weekly Friday email, and in there, in a couple places, you'll see donate now or donate online. We welcome anyone who might be joining us for one of your first times, and we invite you to join our email list by visiting our website, www.slctroy.com, and in the upper right corner, you'll see Join Email List. If you will just click on that, insert your name and email address, we'll see that you receive every Friday morning the weekly email from the church, which includes the link for the upcoming Sunday service, as well as a link for any upcoming classes. In addition, we'll have information about all the upcoming events, which you are welcome to be a part of. If you have a prayer request, send these to ronaldfscott@gmail.com, and we will forward these to our powerful prayer team that is delighted to support you and your loved ones. Next Sunday, I will be speaking about how each of us can deal effectively with the adversity that is certain to face us now and then. This past week, you received an email offering you the gift of a CD that has been prepared of dear Lenore's wonderful meditations. If you would like to receive this, just let me know by email, ronaldfscott@gmail.com. We hope you'll be able to make the Tyler Picnic coming up on Saturday, July 27th at noon. That's just a week from this Saturday. An email was sent to you June 19th with all the details. Let us know if you have any questions at all. And we hope that people can join together to carpool so that we are able to manage the parking more readily. The deadline to RSVP is this coming Saturday, July 20th. Immediately following the end of today's service, everyone is invited to join us on Zoom for a time of social connection. The link was in our Friday email. But first, let's join together in our peace song and benediction. God bless.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as Creator, family all are we. Let me walk with my family in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my joyous vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it be.
And now as you go forth, know that the light of God surrounds you, the love of God enfolds you.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee.
The power of God protects you.
The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee.
The presence of God watches over you.
The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and grant thee peace.
Wherever you are, God is.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Go your way rejoicing. All is truly well.